Hello, 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 everyone. Welcome to Stoneberry. We are finishing off the last of our quests because that's obviously... The game has said we need to go to the final showdown, which is obviously the end of the game. And before we do that, there are Magilou's Menagerie, which is in Stoneberry, and the Joyful Nordals, which is in Stoneberry. So we should be able to put both these up, and then we'll probably run around, see all of these events we can see. Someone did message me kind of as a FYI. Here's what's going to happen, most likely. I am going to push forward, get to just about the end of the game, and then there'll be a weird little time skip where I'll beat the game, I'll record beat the game off camera.
The Nordal set is complete! Hooray!
Darn it, I didn't realize that was the doll.
Turtles! Turtles! Just in time for the win in circles! Your detective skills truly put mine to shame.
It wouldn't have taken so much time and effort if you'd been willing to help us look. But you'll make it up to us with a suitable discount next time we trade.
Can't you give me a break?
Never mind. Do you have anything for us?
I do mind that. But yeah, here's another letter for
okay,
us.
Okay, yeah, I was hoping that was for some other reason than to just...
I will keep this missive short as my patience with you has expired. Come to the prison island and face your judgment. I will not blame you if you run, but I will consider you a heartless coward of a brother.
Oh, this sounds like a challenge to a fight. Now we're talking my
language. Is that actually Edna?
Let's get going.
Whoever this is, they're just trying to get under your skin.
Oh no, we're definitely going.
Why not let it go and move on?
This is the third letter, not counting any that might not have reached us. I say we should go nip this in the bud.
Yeah, I think so too. If we just keep ignoring it, something might happen to Aizen's sister.
Exactly. I can't allow that. I want to head to Titania and...
Oh, we'll definitely go. There's no question. But yeah, what will happen is after I finish these quests, I'll go to the end, but right before I get to the end boss, I'll cut episode. And then the next episode will actually be back out here, because apparently when you go into the final dungeon, a bunch of stuff unlocks, and once you beat the game, a bunch of stuff unlocks. But I do kind of want the last episode to be the end of the game, you know? I mean, that just makes sense. I don't want the game to end and then there's a whole bunch of other content, so... I very much doubt I'll be doing the, like, EX dungeon that sometimes unlocks. Like, I mean, nothing that's going to take hours and hours and hours. But yeah, I'll come out here, see the quests, do the stuff that seems reasonable to do. Yeah, that's the plan. But before we go to help Aizen's sister, we got some other stuff to do. I thought I'd say Aizen's sister, even though I freaking know her name's Edna.
I still have a long way to go before I perfect my new drink, but I did discover something useful already. If you steep the radish bells in barley wine, the poison is denatured, leaving behind a hearty flavor.
Sounds like snake wine.
Exactly. That's where I got the idea.
So, can I get a taste of your new concoction?
Don't tell me I have to wait 50 years for this one, too.
I just started brewing it up. It should be ready after the summer. But my intuition is telling me to let it sit for 4 years.
In that case, we'll come back next autumn. Make sure to save enough for two.
Nah, two won't be enough. I want to treat the whole crew.
You don't even know if it's
How
good.
How much can you make by then?
I've already prepped 3 large barrels. If I push, I could probably ready another 7.
Great. Make them. I'll pay for all 7. And we'll split 5 barrels in the autumn.
What? And we'll come for the other 2 in 4 years' time. Right, Aizen?
No. We'll only take 1 more. The last one is yours to sell as the town's specialty.
Oh, thank you. I'll make sure it's delicious. Looking forward to it.
I mean, I guess you are paying for it up front. I'm like, that's a lot of work for a guy on the promise that, oh yeah, we'll totally come back, don't worry.
She had the idea to build a great bell tower and make it the symbol of our town. We'll make the tower out of stone, tall and proud. Then we'll hang the biggest bell in the land here. The wind whistling down from the mountains will carry the sound far, far away. Wouldn't that be wonderful?
Yeah, it sounds great.
Where are you going to quarry the stone?
The stone we get from the mountains near here is dense and smooth. Perfect for constructing buildings with.
You know your rocks.
When I was deciding on where and what to farm here, I spent a lot of time researching the nearby geology.
Not only does she have the knowledge, she has a great logical mind. She's been a terrific help in getting this plan off the ground.
And he's got the good ideas, but he tends to leap before he looks. Since I don't get flashes of insight like he does, he's given me all sorts of ideas for...
Well, sounds like it's really working out.
Now we're trying to find the perfect metal for the bell.
The metals and their ratios used when casting the bell will change its sound dramatically, right?
That's right. We're testing all sorts of alloys, trying to find one that produces a smooth, pleasing sound.
I hope you can find a sound that will soothe the hearts of those both near and far.
I'm trying to remember, is there a stone grave with a bell in Zesteria? I bet there is, I've just completely forgotten about it. Was that the second village we get to? Because I do remember there was like a tower in there, I don't remember a bell. But it was the one in the land you start with, you start off and you're at your home with, I almost said Magilou. The M gun. None of it. Dang it! I have completely forgotten the character name so bad. Miclio, there we go. With Miclio. And you then leave and you go down to the, like, kingdom capital, with Alicia. And after that, you leave, and I feel like you might come here, because there's this, like, foresty place. But man, it's been years.
Hello. We were hoping we could put on a comedy act here.
Well, even she's...
Who's your partner?
Me.
I'm going to be honest. I think you'll be the worst of any of them.
Just underestimate me. I have my own sense of humor. Just act like we're both aboard the Von Eltia.
I already have a bad feeling about this. All right. You can play the strong, forceful type, and I'll be the dumb, slow one who...
No. I want to play the dumb character.
Are you sure you can handle that?
I'll have everyone dying from laughter the way only a Reaper can.
I don't think I like where this is going.
I'm looking forward to it, though.
Hi there! We're your friendly comedy duo, Death by Laughter!
Magic Kazam!
Line.
Thank you all for coming here to see us today. Now, when you think of Rakugo, you of course think of classic characters like Hatsuan, Kuma-san.
Do we know what Rakugo is?
And there's the neighborhood retiree, and Yotaro the fool who...
Whoa, hold it! What are you rambling on about?
Does it matter? I'm just trying to get a feel for the audience. Every comedian does it.
Not anymore! Speed is key nowadays. Speed! You need to be snappy and get straight to the point!
Well, I object. Comedy that forgets the old classics has no future.
What's old is tired. Comedy is always evolving. It has to!
You must be some new wave type, then.
Did you just click your tongue at me?
No.
Here, and don't you forget it! If you respect comedy, then respect my authority!
Sorry.
Alright, as long as you understand. Now, what are you thinking of doing today?
I was thinking of maybe imitating a clock.
Cut that out! I can't take this anymore! You're impossible!
It's been a while since I worked so
hard. That was great.
I really tried to practice so the jokes would land. How do you think it went?
Your jokes were... okay, I suppose. But your partner was so intimidating. I couldn't laugh.
Huh? Oh, can't say I'm surprised. Your attention, please. I've tabulated the results and I've come to the conclusion that... you're all hopelessly unfunny. I'm sorry.
I don't really care how it moves, but when you put it that way, I get a little pissed off.
Anyway, that's why I'll be teaming up with Bienfu to take on Magilou.
Works for me! I'm ready when you are, Miss Magilou! Which bit are you gonna do? Your specialty, Cat Emperor, or the surefire automaton assault?
Neither. We need brute force to win, so I'm going with Elysian Thunder!
Which means that when things are at their peak, we're gonna hit the audience with lots of thunder, right?
Right.
Oh, don't give it away!
In the form of
everything, as much as we can possibly handle!
Okay! I'll scout out some local material we can use for our opening warm-up, too!
Great! You do that!
You two are really in sync.
Couldn't you two just have teamed up from the start?
But we would have missed all these skits!
Like the whole thing was an elaborate joke, just so she could have this punchline.
Well, now with that settled, let's make our way to Logres and meet up with Magilou.
Oh good, there's another one. Fantastic. I love it. Alright, and then you have a scene to see.
Every time this time of year comes I can't help but think back on that terrible accident.
Can you tell us about it?
This was all quite a long time ago, but a carriage transporting suspects to a heresy trial fell down a ravine.
Oh wow.
I was the one who first found them. And let me tell you, it was a nasty sight.
Oh, right. I remember hearing about this.
I don't. This
well,
terrible.
There were people who'd made a killing running dodgy shows. So their luck might have just caught up with them.
Did anybody survive?
Apparently not. But I heard there was one body they never found.
Right. She was a girl they'd made a part of their show. I heard they really abused her and
forced
her to work for them. I hope she managed to escape, but I don't know.
There were rumors that a strange spirit saved her life. As if anyone could believe a story like that.
Yeah, I heard that too. But the crash happened in the deep mountainside wilderness. It's much more likely that she was eaten by a beast.
This is brutal.
I'm surprised you know so much about it. It happened when
Is Magilou the girl?
Exactly how old are you, Magilou?
As old as my tongue and a little older than my teeth.
From your reaction, I can at least tell you're not my age.
Go on, take a good look.
Okay, wow, that was a really morbid one to end Stoneberry on. Holy crap. Okay, there is something at the inn. I was like, I haven't actually gone inside the inn. I don't see it. There it is. Glad I checked. We have no beverages left. We'll do no beds you can rest in.
Benwick told me that you can mop the floor with the water you've used for washing rice, and it'll make the wood shiny. Is that true?
Just don't do it the opposite way.
Not only does it get the floor clean, it'll put on a layer of rice bran oil at the same time. Two birds with one stone.
Wow, that's awesome! I didn't know that!
Yeah. Rice water has a lot of uses. The first time you use a new earthenware pot, boil rice water in it, and you'll extend its lifespan. And if you use it when you're rehydrating dried fish, it'll tenderize it and take away the fishy smell too.
Interesting.
And if you water plants with it, it acts as a fertilizer. It's really useful stuff.
Wow, look at you, Velvet. Maybe I could see you with a family after all.
You don't have to act so surprised.
Still, I've never read that in any of my books before. How did you end up learning all that?
I learned from Celica, who learned it from our mom. It's just been passed down across the family.
Wow. What else did you learn from your sister?
It is weird that her sister is
Celica
basically Lafayette's mom.
About cooking. From the basics to more advanced techniques. Speaking of which, rice water is really useful when cooking, too. If you use it to boil radishes, it'll get rid of their bitter taste. When you use it to boil bamboo shoots or burdock roots, they'll soften and take on a nice white color. My mother taught Celica that anyone who threw away rice water wasn't qualified for housework, and my sister passed it on to me, too.
You know so many cool things!
When I needed to make my When you need to make a child eat their vegetables, it'll go over better if you can cook them tender and not so bitter.
I'm surprised she can't even say it.
Make a pretty good mom one day, Velvet.
You really think so? Actually, since you're here, Bienfu, I have to ask. Those are discarded vegetables on your tray there, aren't they?
Yeah, but they're just raw scraps left over from cooking. I was on my way to throw them out just now.
What are you talking about? That's all still good stuff you can use. Look at those radish leaves. Dice them up, fry them in oil, add soy sauce, cooking wine, bonito flakes, and sesame seeds, and voila! A perfectly healthy topping for rice. And that potato skin? If you wipe the inner side on a mirror, it won't fog up. Put some salt on those lemon rinds, and you can use them to scrub a wash basin sparkling clean.
Holy cow, Velvet! You're a treasure trove.
Your treasure trove of never throwing anything away ever.
It's been bothering me. These pirates are way too wasteful with their food. They leave so much garbage.
You might be getting a little carried away here.
Yeah, I think you've made the jump from potential mom to bothersome in-law.
They really need scenes like this, where you just, especially after that, like, really morbid scene that we had at the end of the last one. Oh my god. That was a thing. Okay. So now we need to go to Logres and finish up that, and then go to, our old hideout. So let's get moving. Thankfully, I can skateboard all the way. I do have to be careful, though. I'm pretty sure these guys will actually make me fight them if I run into them. So let's try and avoid that. I also do want to stop by at that one roost where we almost fought a dragon. Because nothing ever came of that, other than the fact that... was it... It wasn't Aizen, it was... Oh, Wind Boy from Zesteria. I am so good with names, you guys, I swear. It's going to be really bad if I ever am, like, worried that I am having a stroke. They won't be able to find out by, like, well, do you know who this is? I don't know who anyone is! Zavi, there we go. I'll get it eventually. This was such a good fake out where it was just like, oh, there's a save point, another climb bar. Is there actually anything up here this time? There is not. Okay, so that may be something that happens after we either beat the game or some other event occurs. Just love how decisive I am. That's gonna be something after either we beat the game or an event other than us beating the game. But definitely an event has to occur. Whee! Whee! I've forgotten the button. Yeah, let's go to Logres. Because that's a little bit of a run, and we've got the in-off bottle, so why the heck not? I bet it's that other one.
I thought I could make things work out if I just got to the capital, but finding a job here isn't easy.
We worked so hard and lived so well in that town. Why did this have to happen to us?
We should tell the Abbey what happened. They'll help us and kill all those evil demons.
We know that place better than anyone. We can help the Abbey recapture it. I'll never forgive those demons or the Lord of Calamity. I'm sorry.
I mean, obviously you don't know it that well if we can stand right here and you don't realize that we're here. So I feel like that is probably the showdown. Oh, there is quite a bit. And there also is something in the tavern. So maybe this isn't. If you can't tell, we're finally going around and actually seeing all this stuff before we get to the end of the game.
Showtime, Magilou! Come out and face me, preferably unprepared.
Magilou isn't doing any shows right now.
Hmm? Why not? Oh, did she get scared when she heard that the Enfu and I were teaming up?
No. Magilou and her teacher had a big fight. From what I've heard, it sounds like she's run away from home.
Do you know what happened?
She just kept going on about how she wanted a break from practicing.
So? She's young. She probably just wants to go out and have some fun.
Yeah, that's understandable.
Preposterous. If she takes even one day off, it takes three to get her back in form.
Even so, shouldn't you at least hear her out?
Yeah, she's not a machine.
Hear her out. She mentioned something about wanting to go to the Zamal Grotto, but I wouldn't have any...
Did you say Zamal Grotto? That place is a nest of vicious demons.
What?
Vicious demons, you say? If Magilou really...
No, Magilou!
...then victory could end up being mine by default.
This isn't a joking matter. We have to go look for Magilou.
Oh, my precious Lulu.
Interesting. Okay, not what I expected at all. I wanted a big, good, funny trope scene. So where's the grotto? Zamal Grotto. Oh, no wonder I hadn't heard of it. Okay. We'll still finish off Logres in terms of, like, all these scenes. And then we'll start making our way to Zamal Grotto. Because even though I actually really want to...
Take a look at this.
A new recipe!
Oh, Terra Island Eyewitness Info? Sure, I'll look at that as well.
The map's really getting filled out now.
You seem really happy, Lafayette.
Yeah, you just had a big old grin on your face.
Well, yeah, wait. Of course. Surely even you have some times when you can't help but smile.
Velvet never smiles.
I never thought about it. You know, I guess I do. Like when I managed to get the kitchen and the dishes sparkling and spotless.
Oh!
Well, that's so domesticated.
I feel that way when I get the bathtub scrubbed so clean that it's as good
as... Man, I'm feeling like a pig.
Oh, and when I finish hanging a huge load of laundry out to dry on a beautiful sunny day.
Could you not compare this to doing chores?
The scouting vessel just contacted us. They say they found Terror Island.
Terror Island?
Yeah, that...
What kind of place is that?
Aizen was talking about it earlier. It apparently moves around.
Oh, it's like the place in Symphonia.
Legends say it's roamed the outer seas since time immemorial. They say it absorbs power from all of existence.
That sounds like it might be connected to Enominat.
We won't know anything more until we go there ourselves.
Okay, more side quests.
We should join up with the crew at the docks in Isolt.
Interesting, why Isolt specifically?
Hey, it's you guys. Remember me? We met during that whole thing with the Swordbreaker. You convinced me to stop being banned.
Yes, I remember you. You made it to Logres.
Yeah, I finally saved enough to open up my Bandit Cuisine restaurant. I'm just looking for the right location now.
Bandit Cuisine?
You didn't steal that money, did you?
Hey, I said I stopped being a bandit, didn't I?
I didn't say when.
I had honest work to save up for this. Repairing roads, delivering relief supplies, lots of hard labor.
You really did turn over a new leaf. I think what you've done is incredible.
Really? All right. It was all worth it just to see that smile.
Now that you've become a good man, I'm sure that even more wonderful things will come your way.
Have you decided on your menu?
Almost. I've got the eggless wild mushroom omelette and the highwayman's stew, but I feel like I need one more standout dish. There's a tavern in this town that has Mabo curry that's just out of this world.
Oh, it's really good, yeah.
Do you have any good ideas for me? Maybe something that'll help me draw in the ladies?
Maybe add a dessert menu? That might help. I know, like a theft by chocolate cake. Or a roasted pear crème brûlée tart.
Well, that's certainly aggressive.
Yeah, those sound great. Now my menu's complete. Hey, when I'm a big success, you wanna get hitched?
You shouldn't tease an exorcist.
I'm not teasing. I'm serious.
Okay, you don't even know her.
Well, good luck with your restaurant.
Ooh, rejection hurts.
Miss Holier Than Thou delivered some just desserts. Sweet rejection. It'd make a good cake name.
The taste of defeat is bittersweet.
Okay, again, I'm enjoying these entirely more than I think is possibly healthy. But yeah, I like this because you end up, like, it's a nice little... Where everyone is before you, like, dive into...
The calamity has brought fear to the entire kingdom. Grim whisperings echo through the streets in every town.
It's gloom and grief all around. So many people at church have lost someone close to them.
But it is in the saddest times when smiles are most needed. Dark expressions cast dark shadows.
Smile in the face of sadness.
Now that's a real man. That old guy knows what's what.
I'm not saying you need to make light of everything, but try to leave a little room for joy in your life.
Like when you eat good food, or see a beautiful flower.
Or even this fountain. Water wells forth, a symbol of hope. Even though life may be hard, I keep at it. I work hard so that this fountain never runs dry.
And I'll help you maintain it, so that it stays a place where people can come to feel at ease.
Again, oh my gosh, I wish I knew which of these cities existed in Zestiria. I do feel like I've heard of Logres in Zestiria, but I don't think we actually came here. But I very well might be wrong. Was this the... It looks nothing like the capital city.
Now that there are less exorcists around, we can rely on the Abbey to do everything for us.
We need to start by doing what we can do to make this world a brighter place.
So where are you going to start?
With everything as harsh as it is now, people feel like they need to sacrifice excess and live frugally. I agree that we should act in moderation and refrain from excessive luxury. But we need joy to keep us going, right?
That's why we've decided to open up a restaurant. We want to make people...
Wait, how many restaurants are being opened in this town?
Good drink.
What sort of food will you make?
That's what I'm researching now. I'm walking the world, trying different foods.
I heard they have this amazing Mabo curry. But to be honest, the place looks a little intimidating.
Just treat it like it's any other restaurant. I've been in there, and the Mabo curry is great.
Really? So it's a Mabo curry even the kids can like? I gotta try me some of this.
I wish you wouldn't call me a kid.
I mean, you do look like one.
I didn't mean to step on your pride there. I was too preoccupied with thinking about our restaurant's mission statement, and I neglected to consider your feelings. I'm terribly sorry.
It's not that big of a deal. But what do you mean by mission statement anyway?
I don't know why people are so obsessed with mission statements.
Fun for the whole family. Our slogan is, we'll feed you from the cradle to the grave.
It's supposed to be a place people eat. You might not want to mention graves.
I think a person would need a lot of courage to go eat there.
Whoa. Why didn't I think about that?
You seem to miss a lot. Are you sure you're up for...
Well, I definitely see why... This one doesn't last.
I studied up on a lot of restaurant management, and I plan on hiring a really good chef. All that's left is to select a menu and come up with a new slogan.
Instead of cradle to grave, how about from this life to the next life?
Your food's killing them either way.
Rats. I can't think of anything.
God damn it.
Fine dining, from baby teeth to dentures. Not bad, eh?
That's fantastic. It gets rid of that whole dying thing. I love it. We'll use it.
They've got a long...
Yeah, they definitely do. I don't want to think about dentures while I'm eating. I'll never order anything sticky from your restaurant. Oh, good. Hello.
Welcome.
You came back.
I did. This place is important to me.
Are you sure it's okay to be in a town like this?
Don't worry about us. Besides, I'm more worried about the bar. I'm only away for a little while, and look at this place. The casks are empty, and all the food tastes like dirt. Just a little bit ago, we finally got a delivery in. It was barely enough to open up shop.
Do you have enough to make Mabo curry?
I do.
Great!
Thanks for worrying about us. But leave the town to the townsfolk. You should just focus on what you have to do. Just make sure you don't have any regrets.
Thanks, Tabitha.
Oh wow, you got another one. I almost walked away.
I heard you guys managed to beat Shigure Rangetsu.
Sure did.
It travels fast again, as usual.
As I understand it, succession of the Rangetsu clan goes to the one who kills his predecessor. That means you're the successor, Rokuro. Or have you taken the name Shigure now?
You have to kill the head of the clan?
Yeah, that's a terrible...
I don't intend to step up as the new head. But how do you know about my family?
Do you forget who she is?
We're all part of the same underworld. Word travels. A long time ago, we tried to assassinate another Shigure. But we lost 30 of our number instead.
Naturally. It'd take more than that to do a Shigure in.
In retrospect, I wonder if even 300 men would have been enough. Your Shigures are a tough bunch. Look at your brother. He was a legate.
Yeah. He was probably the strongest head the clan ever had.
That being said, did you know there's a demon out there?
Oh god, don't give me another one.
Managed to cut down.
Are you serious?
That must be some crazy demon if a legate couldn't even take it down.
Tell me about it.
It was a swordsman who looked like a dragon. Shigure was sent to exterminate it, but came away empty-handed. And quite recently, it was sighted at the Empyrean's.
Why, we're going there.
Sounds like a job only I can handle.
Wait. You're not the only one here. Only fools rush in.
Don't bother, Magilou.
Yeah, you should know better. He won't listen.
Besides, I think we're all fools here.
Point taken.
That is actually very fair.
Swordsman, not even Shigure could kill. I'm getting excited just thinking about it.
Good luck.
All right. And with that, I'll go ahead and end this episode. When we come back, I will have gone to where Lulu went. You'll have forgotten her other name, the Magilou's rival. Get that done, and then we're going to start making our way towards the prison island, because we are just filling up on side quests, let me tell you what. You know what? I'm here for it. See you next time, and thank you for tuning in.